Recall that in the case of a single crystal, material properties such as elasticity, strength, hardness, and others can all be dependent upon which atomic plane the testing force is applied. Because of this, researchers need to know how the atomic planes are oriented within the sample. In order to accomplish this, Laue can be performed. In a Laue experiment, we have an X-ray source, some sort of film, and the sample. Just to clarify, the sample does not need to be any particular shape. I just used a cube as an example. The X-rays are shot through the center of the film, strike the sample, and are reflected back to the film, producing a pattern like this. Each one of these dots corresponds to a diffraction peak for a particular atomic plane. Utilizing software in the lab, we can determine which planes the dots belong to. The dot that I made green belongs to the 100 plane, which is the plane on which I wanted to test. The software not only identifies the planes, but it can also tell you how to rotate the sample in 3D space to make it perpendicular to the X-ray beam. Using our goniometers, I rotated the sample, ran another test, and found that the 100 plane was now in the center of the pattern, which means that it is perpendicular to the X-ray beam. I then cut the sample so that the new face would correspond to the 100 plane. Additional experiments could be performed to cut more faces to correspond to whichever planes are desired. That brings us to the end of the video. If you would like more information about the JIAM diffraction facility or have any questions, here is the address for our website and my email address. Thank you for watching.